Speaking of incredible, our next guest is a three-time Olympic gold medalist turned actress, and today she is here to talk about our new Hallmark Channel original movie, Love, of Course. Please welcome Gabby Douglas. Welcome, Gabby!
Wow.
Great to see you.
You too.
I mean, we had so much fun on filming this movie. Wasn't it a great vibe on this film?
It was so amazing. We were just all, we loved having a good time, laughing, joking.
So much good stuff behind the scenes. Now, here's the thing that you probably don't know, because maybe you're used to it out there. But every time you came on, everybody was so excited. There was
really?
Like a buzz on set when you were there. Yeah, people were really jacked. And by the way,
sweet.
Sam's kind of here today, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, people have come from near and far. We have people who actually flew in from Minnesota to see
what?
Gabby. Not a joke.
You're impressive.
Right,
let's get back to the film here for a sec. Tell us about your character, Maddie. Obviously, I know a little bit, but tell everybody else.
So I play Maddie Seaton, and her granddad owns an apple orchard. And she's very charismatic. She's very fun, which was amazing because, you know, that kind of reminded me of myself.
Aww.
So it fit.
Nice.
Well, we have a clip from the movie where Maddie and her friend Kara, who is your co-star, Kelly Rutherford's
daughter. That's right, yeah.
Are working at the apple orchard.
Yep.
But they're less interested in what's happening with the apples and more interested in something else. Let's take a look.
Yes.
Hey, Mrs. Andolini.
Mr.
Hey, girls. What are you both doing here? My grandfather has an orchard, and I help out sometimes. And I'm just helping Maddie out today. Don't worry, I promise both of you guys, I'm caught up with all my courses.
Yeah, that's a good thing, because one of your professors just might have a pop quiz coming up.
No. Oh, good.
So you know.
Your grandfather is...
Yeah, Edward Seaton. Yeah, one of our sponsors.
Okay, I knew the name. I was actually going to reach out to him about upping his sponsorship.
Oh, well, is he at the orchard today by any chance?
Every Saturday.
Okay, perfect.
This is great.
Now you get to see some farming.
Yay.
Good to see you guys.
Bye.
Bye.
See ya.
There was so much said with just this. All they did was look at each other, and we know what's going to happen, Cameron.
Listen, you got to tune in
and
find out.
We know what's going to happen. I think it's going to end up really well for the two of you. So, Gabby, this isn't your first acting role, but you did say that this is the most exciting acting role you've ever had, because Hallmark movies are a huge deal in your family.
Yes, they're a huge deal. I, like, binge, and I think I've watched, like, every single Hallmark movie, which is, like...
And your mom does.
Oh, my mom, my family, and we all do, so.
Oh, I mean, it's
just so good.
Night.
I mean,
it's hard not to watch the Hallmark
movies.
It's
very hard, and you, like, know what's going to happen, but you, like, you still have to watch it.
You have to. It's such a feel-good experience.
It is.
Yeah,
it is.
That's what we go for. So it's a big deal in your household, Hallmark movies. Another big deal, you know, three-time gold medalist.
Yeah,
I'd say. Also a bit of a big deal.
A little
bit. Here's the interesting fact that a lot of people may or may not know is that that almost didn't happen for you, because almost kind of gave up on gymnastics before those 2012 Olympics.
Yeah, so in 2012, I had moved away, or 2011, I moved away at the age 14 to achieve my goals, and I was training with this new coach. And so then I was just excited for the journey, I was excited for the process, but I'm very family-oriented,
right.
And so I missed my family, and the Olympics was coming around. Ooh. I was getting super scared, and I wanted to quit and work at Chick-fil-A. Just before the games.
Oh my goodness.
I love how specific it is. It's not like I want to get on a job someplace. It's like,
you know, I love their sweet tea.
Yes,
the best sweet tea in the world, really.
Their lemonade.
True story.
All right.
But you didn't quit.
Yeah. I didn't quit. My support system rallied behind me and helped me.
And you know what? It's like you're downplaying it and you're being really humble, but come on, Gabby. It's a good thing you didn't quit, because not only did you win at the Olympics.
I want to be a part of the Hallmark.
That's right.
Don't worry. I think you could be part of the Hallmark. But it's not every day that someone can be a three-time Olympic gold medalist. It's very rare.
No.
As a matter of fact, so rare that not only did you go and win, you made history. You broke every record there was. I'm giving myself chills telling your story. So just so I can get it correct and so everyone else at home knows exactly how amazing what you did is, you were the first African-American gymnast to become the individual all-around champion and the first American gymnast, but boy or girl, by the way, to win gold in both individual all-around and team competitions. I mean, you, like, you broke the internet. How did that feel?
It felt phenomenal. You know, I've been training every single day, working so hard, and just to be up on that podium and just to be able to just stand there and said, wow, I did it, you know? Hallmark, ending. So. Yeah, it's literally.
We gotta write this movie, Gabby. We gotta write this Hallmark
Let's
movie.
Let's do it.
Come on,
all right.
Come on.
All right.
It's already written for us. What am I talking about?
I mean, your family must have been so proud.
Oh man, they have given up so much for me to be able to go and achieve my dreams, and so I couldn't be here without any of them. So I'm so appreciative.
Could you know, in that moment, can you feel like, wow, how big this is? Or is it just so overwhelming that you really, until days later, you go, oh, my gosh.
It is so overwhelming. I'm still getting used to it. I'm like, you know me? Like, how do you know me? And so, I don't know. It's just, it's crazy, honestly. And I'm just so honored.
Yeah, really. I mean, obviously, the amount of work that goes into something like that is astounding. And you went
dedication.
On, you
kept
dedication, and you went on and won gold again in 2016 at those Olympics as well. So you definitely weren't letting up at all. And you've mentioned that so much of your time was spent training in a gym. That as a child, as a young adult, as
one
a child,
off.
You get one day off.
Goodness.
That you didn't develop a lot of the hobbies that some people
exactly.
out there have. But now. You're kind of making
now
up
I'm living
that,
life, exactly. I'm
tell
skateboarding.
Us about you are?
I'm skateboarding. I'm doing more acting.
Yes.
I play music, ice skating, cooking.
What are some of your favorites? What are you looking forward to the most that you used to look forward, to gymnastics? So what are some of your faves?
I guess experiencing and really doing the things that I didn't get to enjoy. Like, I wasn't allowed to ride a bike, swim, and so,
just in case you were going to hurt yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, my
and
gosh.
Just in case if I swallowed water, got sick, I couldn't make the Olympics. It was... They're paranoid.
Well, let me tell you something. You're in the right place because we have so many activities in this house.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. Listen, great to see you.
You too.
Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
Especially Love, of Course, everybody. Be sure to watch it. Love, of Course, Gabby is there for sure. I will be in it a little bit myself tomorrow
just
at 8, 7 Central, right here on Hallmark Channel.